Dear Lord, Jesus once said, suffer little children to come unto me. I finally understand what he meant. Those who aren't worthy.
Have you seen Harry or not?
I swear to you, Lord, they'll be the ones who suffer. Amen.
What have you got there?
A bit of good news for once. So, Laurie has decided to plead guilty, which means there won't be a trial or Sinead is going to be over the moon.
Oh, wonderful. You should call Tony.
No, he's got enough on his plate. And he's been out all night looking for Harry. I don't want to remind him of what Laurie did, so... Oh, finally! Any luck?
I've been through Harry's address book. I've called all his old mates. None of them know where he's gone. Which is my fault for pushing him away.
It's probably fine. Just has other priorities. I should go. My Aunt Miriam said we can stop with her till I get myself back on my feet.
You know, that voicemail he left me, he had something important to say, then it just cut off. Diane, what if something bad's happened to him?
You know, you're just feeling guilty because you parted on bad terms. Go and get some sleep.
Oh, he came back to get something to eat. I'm going to keep looking.
Diane's right. You should drop the kiddies off at Tom's Turtles. Let me take care of it. I could make one of my famous lasagnas.
I can't just sit around and do nothing.
Because of my toxic jealousy and paranoia. I don't think 40 winks is gonna help.
James, you're scaring me. Look, instead of falling apart over what you've lost, how about you focus on what you have? A family.
Romeo and Juliet need to find out what kind of man I really am. And it won't be long before they discover the truth.
Look, I realise it was me who encouraged you to make amends with Harry, but James, he's gone now. But obsession in the name of a broken heart. Darling, that was your father's speciality.
You're right. I'm on a path to hatred and self-destruction. And if I don't stop now, who knows where it'll lead?
Look, we need to make this quick before we open.
Where's Silver?
Got to get some foot barbecue. Look, what are we going to do about Harry?
Relax. While you were out flipping burgers with Tall, Dark and Gormless, I was making inquiries. Harry's disappeared. Good news for us.
How is that good news? He knew that I was the one driving the car.
If he was going to go to the police, he would have done it by now. My guess is, you scared him into doing a runner. You're a nasty piece of work. It's like looking in the mirror.
This is a game, Liam. I've threatened to kill the lad.
Why do you care so much about Harry anyway?
Because it's not just about Harry, is it? It's about everyone, everything. Silver, Sadie, Grace. This is all closing in on us, Liam, and it's going to end badly.
Someone's gone to a lot of trouble. What's the occasion?
Ah. Don't spoil your dessert.
The numerous sins of James Nightingale. Dear Romeo and Juliet, once upon a time there was a wonderfully wicked man who who drugged Harry, sabotaged his plea hearing, and pimped him out. And our brave hero tricked your mother into confessing to Mac's murder and left her to languish in prison. No, James, no. I mean, Juliet can't possibly know this, and... I mean, it's deranged. It's sick.
Well, I'm turning into my father. Best they have fair warning.
I'm not going to let you push away people who love you.
Who could ever love me? I'm a hateful, pathetic excuse for a man.
I'm telling you, you are worrying over nothing. Harry's probably in France, sipping Chardonnay by now. Do you really want to spoil all that for him because you feel guilty?
If only I'd listened to him instead of making him feel like a complete screw-up. You know, maybe he'd still be here.
You mustn't blame yourself. Some things are in the Lord's hands.
You know, when I first met Harry, he was a complete stranger to me. I don't want a life without my son. That's why I'm not giving up until he tells me everything's all right.
You checked the cab office for clues, because if he ordered a taxi out of here, they'll know where he went.
Thanks, Breeder. You're all right for a McQueen.
In the dog car park.
Right, you. No more arguments. You're coming home and getting some rest.
Okay.
What?
Harry's just text from France. He's safe. He's forgiven me for yesterday. I feel like such an idiot for making everyone worry.
Oh, no, Tony, that's great. You know, maybe now we can... Well, you can finally come home and take it easy. Right, let's go and grab a cuppa, yeah? Breeder, will you join us?
No, thanks. I've got an errand to run. I should have done it last night, but little baby Isaac was keeping me busy. So I shall see you later.
OK, Mr. Breeder, you got a flat tyre there? Let me fix it for you.
No, that's so kind, I can manage. I've never been shy of hard work. Idle hands are the devil's workshop. Thank you.
See you later.
Breeder, have you seen Harry?
I'm sorry, love, I haven't.
Oh, look, this is exactly why I told you to delete that dreadful tracking app, as you promised. Look, I'm terribly sorry about this.
Look, I'm not losing my mind. This app allows me to track Harry's signal. Look, his phone is on and it is in this car park, so where is he?
Sorry, love, I don't know, I swear.
Hey, easy, mate, she said she's not seeing him.
That's not possible, look!
Look, I'm sorry. Sorry about this, darling. Look, can't you see? You're just... James, you are raging out of control. Please, darling, let it end here. Hey, come on. Come on.
Just me, as the nightingales get weirder and weirder.
Yeah, well, it's nothing I can't handle. Anyway... Let's get going.
You fixing that tyre on your own? Should let me know. I would have given you a hand.
I didn't want to be a bother.
Hey, it's no bother. I'll be on the road in no time.
That was... Thank you. My adventure into single motherhood begins. Thank you for everything.
You know, there'll always be a room here for you and Isaac. Good luck.
Oh... You're going to be just fine, I promise. Hello. Yeah, I've got you a little friend.
Oh, thank you.
I'll see you out.
Let's go, hey? Let's go. Oh,
no. Laurie's pleading guilty. Man, that's amazing. Why didn't you say?
Well, I was going to, but you were so worried about Harry.
Oh, darling, I'm sorry. I'm 100% at your disposal from now on, now that I know that Harry's safe. Yeah, I never showed you, did I? Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. Never thought Harry was the emoji type.
He's not. Harry hates emojis. When I use him, he refuses to reply. You know, I never noticed that before. Harry would never send a message like this. Unless... Well, what if somebody else sent it?